Great is the Lord, He is holy and just. By His power we trust in His love. Great is the Lord, He is faithful and true. By His mercy He proves He is love.
Revival Cup started as a Crisco event in the year 2008.
Asante kwa kutupa nguvu na talanta yetu. Tunaomba tukiingia semi ukuwe na sisi. Ndio tupate injury.
As we continued with the tournament, we discovered that there is a need to bring all the young people in Nairobi together in an event that focuses on evangelism, focuses on fellowship, and focuses on mentorship through sport.
We are the Revival Cup Sports Evangelism Team. We are the ones who have been tasked to spread the gospel while the sports event is going on. And first of all, I want to thank God for giving us this opportunity to be able to share the gospel to these young men who have gathered here. We understand which times we are, and these times require that we be able to spread the gospel to each and every person that we encounter.
To work together. One thing I've come to learn about ministry is that when you walk alone, you'll walk very fast. But when you walk with people, you'll go further. As I was just standing right there, being able to see different people, different understanding, I've been able actually been approached by young people individually, and I've been able to take an opportunity to give counsel. I've seen a lot of fellowship between churches, even be able to work together and understand each other. Even in town.
initiative initially originating from the CRISCO National Youth Office, especially from the ministry led by District 1. The purpose of the vision for this ministry was specifically to bring young people together to share with them salvation, which comes from our Lord Jesus Christ. We have been running the project for coming to 12 years. This is our 12th year, and so far the Lord has been very, very faithful. We have had young people getting saved. We have had people, young people who are involved in drug addiction, being assisted. We have had young people who have relationships, bad relationships with parents, coming, owning up, and beginning the process of reconciliation. So it is a ministry where we can comfortably say that it has helped young people be able to develop a closer relationship with their God.
Rover Cup has been a good platform where we are able to minister to young people, where young people interact. And the purpose of this basically began by actually introducing sports evangelism, and it has been a good experience where we young people are exposed, they get to learn a lot. We invite ministers and they are ministered unto. Revival Cup started in the year 2006. Those are like 12, 13 years ago, and it has grown to a big event. Initially, when the event started, we only had a few teams, four or six teams, mainly from CRISCO District 1, under the leadership of Elder Charles Jenga. But we opened up the event to other districts within CRISCO, and finally to other churches within Nairobi.
And from that time, we've seen a lot of growth. We have been able to grow from the 8 churches that started it to 32 churches that are now playing today.
With 32 teams, that means close to 500 young people are gathered here for this edition, which is a very good thing.
The experience young will come participant, especially when Revival Cup in Kwenanza in the year 2009. I remember that year I was still a player. It enabled us even to network between my church, that is the case in James Buruburu, with other churches. That time it was CRISCO, I remember St. Andrews. But now even as more churches have grown, you know, ministries for everyone, got to meet other people who are reaching out to young people.
So siku leo mekuwepo, tumekuwa hapa kuanzia asubuhi. Tournament ilikuwa inaanza exactly at 9. So tunashukuru Mungu. This time teams are more committed. Teams are growing stronger by every tournament. Today I was representing Kiamlams Limited, and unfortunately we did not manage to go to the next round. We have been knocked out from the group stages. But I can just say that the competition is growing stiff every day. And I believe by the grace of God, He's going to take us to the next level. So, kudos to the best team that we win today, because actually it's a big competition, and we are getting to see new talents every time. The ladies also are coming up well, so tunashukuru pia madam onye ametokea. they're making the competition interesting and more joyous. So
God has given us souls. The gospel is changing the young men that are around this place. And we are seeing people being delivered. We are seeing people being healed by the testimonies that we are receiving from them.
My name is Margaret Modoni. I'm born again, praise the Lord. And I'm from Crisco, Githurai. I'm grateful to God for this opportunity that has given us to serve Him through evangelism, and also having an opportunity to come and preach and share the word of God with our friends and brethren from different churches.
In relation to what is happening here, I think for me, I applaud the people that came behind the Revival Cup. These are great ideas. That's why I myself actually had even to come on the ground in relation to what I've seen. Number one, I would see the issue of fellowship. Be able to work together. One thing I've come to learn about ministry is that when you walk alone, you'll walk very fast. But when you walk with people, you'll go farther. As I was just standing right there, being able to see different people, different understanding, I've been able actually been approached by young people individually, and I've been able to take an opportunity to give counsel. I've seen a lot of fellowship between churches, even be able to work together and understand each other.
Sports is the medium. Yeah, we are using football, but the message is still the same, the message of Jesus Christ. And I'm sure that even as this tournament grows, we'll get to reach out to more young people in this beautiful city of ours.
But we're thanking God for the outcome. The people have really turned up, and they're really grateful and really wanting to hear the word of God. As much as they're playing, they're giving us their ears to hear what we have to share and also encourage them in the process.
We have had young people getting saved. We have had people, young people who are involved in drug addiction being assisted. We have had people who have, young people who have relationships, bad relationships with parents coming, owning up, and beginning the process of reconciliation. So it is a ministry where we can comfortably say that it has helped young people be able to develop a closer relationship with their God.
Again, the award and the champion!
And some people have given their lives to Jesus Christ, about 8 so far, and we thank God for that. One thing we have also realized is that among the 8, majority of them don't have churches which they go to, and that also informs us the importance of doing follow-up and also enjoining them to churches where they will be fellowshipping. That's why we are also taking their mobile phones number so that we can be able to make a follow-up and be able to connect them with people who are going to guide them and also to help them to grow in the Word of God. So we thank God even for this organization, and we pray that the organizers will continue doing this work, and we'll be able to reach out.
And so far we are happy to report that we have had people and organizations of good
interest coming and supporting us. And just to mention but a few, Interconsumer Products are among the people who have worked with us for the longest time. Also Spares and Tiles, these are the experts in roofing. We are also happy to inform us that we have...
Some people have given their lives to Jesus. Quite a number have been helped and counseled in that particular tent by the pastors who are here today. And that has been a very good thing. It is a positive event, and I would encourage every other church to join this event.
So far, we have seen the effectiveness of what we are doing. We have approached the young men. We have spoken about the love of God to them. We have given out our testimonies to them, and we have shown them what Christ has already done for them at the cross of Calvary. And God has given us souls. The gospel is changing the young men that are around this place.
I want to encourage every young person, the moment you hear about this cup, just avail yourself. And so Revival Cup is the way to go for Christian bodies, for the body of Christ, anytime, for the churches within Nairobi. Join up with us and let us give our young people something to look for.
Tatu, nne, tano, sita, saba, nane, kumi.
I always say that it's one kingdom, it's one fellowship, it's one brotherhood, and every youth event should be available to all people, regardless of your church.
But we found it's a good ground to be able to hook up with others and learn a lot.
That way we can reach the youth in Nairobi with the gospel of Christ, gospel of salvation. We can mentor them, we can teach them. And what better way than sports? Sports is a great force in mobilizing young people. Sports is a popular activity that brings people together. And I know as we continue in this manner, we shall be able to achieve our goal.
We are seeing it being the pillar through which we'll be able to drive our sports evangelism.
God has been faithful to us, God has been good to us, and God has helped us even in all these ways.
You have your youth, you have your talents. Ensure that sports is used as a means of evangelism.
Biashara zao zikaweza wana kunawiri na Mungu wetu wakaweza kuwa wanashikilia vijana hata kwa kazi kama hii na zingine nyingi. Tunaomba amani na baraka zako. Bwana, tunapoondoka kwa pamoja nasi, tufunika magari ambayo tutakayotumia na damu ya Yesu Kristo, na tunaomba Bwana ukatupa safari iliyo bora. Bwana, tunakuomba na kutukabidhi hata matarajio yetu yakiwa katika 2020, Bwana, wakati tutakapotayarisha hata mchezo mwingine. Tunakuomba na tunakuheshimu na tukatika jina Yesu Kristo, tunaomba.
Exalted for